Harvard's Dean of Admissions, the top dog, has testified in federal court. Welcome everybody to another episode of AZNN, where I will be giving you my hot takes on Asian news. So in this video, we're gonna be talking about Harvard University is officially on trial for discriminating against Asian applicants, and there's updates. A lot more Asians are running for office, and there's a lot of winning going on. Drama Fever, everybody's favorite Asian drama streaming site, and a lot more. This is a pen. Every good Asian news show has a pen. Let's go. There are new updates on the Harvard case about discriminating against Asian applicants. Harvard's Dean of Admissions, the top dog, has testified in federal court. Harvard does lower its standards when admitting applicants from rural regions, except if they're Asian American. Boom! That's a blow. Basically saying that they do not want too many Asians. While there are a ton of Asians who get admitted to Harvard every year, there's also a lot that are getting turned down who are also highly qualified, but it's because they're not ranking very high on the personality score. So for most colleges, like the one that I went to, they're not gonna have a personality scale. They're not going to judge that. They're really just gonna care about your score, your GPA, and maybe some few outside activities. What's made people mad is that some Asians who are probably qualified and probably had better personalities than they showed are getting rejected, while a lot of other Asians are getting rejected purely just because they have the test scores and the grades. There's highly qualified Asian applicants who could be fun and effervescent and have great personalities, but got rejected because they play violin and they do other stereotypical Asian student things. This case is basically being used to take race completely off the admissions table, which we know does affect a lot of other groups beyond Asians. When one group shows that they want something so bad, and in this case, it's Asians wanting to go to Harvard, that desire can be used by other people for their ulterior motive. For more on that, I will leave a link down below. Here are my questions for you guys. Number one, should Asians really care that much about going to Harvard? Why does this seem to be the only thing that co-signs somebody as like a great person? Basically, once you've gone to Harvard to most Asian families, you are already successful. You don't have to do anything else for the rest of your life. Literally, you don't have to even be a good person. You can just go to Harvard. There's something weird about that. Millions of other great Asian people in history did not go to Harvard. Is racial balancing important at Harvard? It is a private university. It is one of the most elite in the entire world, and they do have a legacy. So I don't know. What do you think? Is being on trial going to hurt Harvard's reputation? Because this trial does make Harvard look bad. It does kind of reveal things about their admission process. It does show that they're being stereotypical and clumping people together. Now, will people keep applying? Yeah, I'm pretty sure they will. Another company is on trial, but the unofficial Asian trial, which is 99 Ranch, or should I say Ranch 99. You know you're Asian when one of the most heated debates of the past 2 weeks was whether you call the Asian supermarket 99 Ranch or Ranch 99. There has been tweets, there has been polls, there has been heated debate, there's been evidence shown, and yes, this is only a debate that probably Asian people really care about. Guess what? The chairman has spoken. It is 99 Ranch. That's how you say it. The 99 comes before the ranch. It is not Ranch 99 Market. Although, yes, depending on who built that sign, it is a little confusing. Guys, don't get it twisted. Put some respect on a name. Now it's time for news about Asians in politics. Does anybody care about this section? We'll find out. 13 out of the 24 Vietnamese Americans that are running for office in Orange County have the last name of Nguyen or Nguyen, depending on how you say it. I don't know, I've heard it both ways, but they have the same last name. Now, if you're voting in Orange County, you gotta be very careful of who you are marking down on your ballot. I can't imagine how hard it's gonna be for old non-Asian people to be voting this time. Oh, this is probably the first time in 50 years I'm not voting. Statistically speaking, 40% of Vietnamese around the world have the last name Nguyen. Overall, it's pretty dope that that many Asians want to run for office because local elections are actually very important. Next up is a Texas candidate, Sri Kulkarni, from Houston, who's trying to flip a GOP seat. He is campaigning in 13 different languages. That means on his squad of people that are calling people up, he's got 13 different dialects and languages going on. And not to mention that he is fluent in 6 different languages himself. Who is this man? English, Spanish, Hindi, Mandarin, Russian, and Hebrew. He's fluent in Hebrew. I think candidates like him are the future. As much as the world is trying to speak English, there's a lot of people who are trying to learn other languages too. I think being this inclusive is actually really gonna help him reach out. Can Kulkarni bring the people together. We'll see you in Houston. Drama Fever, which was a lot of people's favorite Asian drama streaming site where they could catch K-dramas, C-dramas, J-dramas, has suddenly shut down. Without warning, they're gone. If you go to the site right now, it's like an apology letter. Rest in peace. Drama Fever. A lot of people are speculating that Drama Fever shut down because the juggernaut Netflix has entered the space of Asian dramas and is now focusing more on Asian content, therefore taking market away from Drama Fever. Right now, already has shows like Meteor Garden, Terrace House, Mr. Sunshine. It's tough because if these were the shows that were going to be on something like Drama Fever and now they're on Netflix and more people watch Netflix, then yeah, it's gonna hurt Drama Fever's market. Now we know Netflix is getting into Asian content. Will they be getting into Asian American content? Is that something that has a market? You guys let me know in the comments below. Now for my last news bit, I'm gonna take it back out east to China, which a lot of funny memes are coming out of because there is a ton of people and they're doing a ton of things and it's funny. So the good people of Chongqing, which is a huge city and also known for its hot pot, has just stepped it up a notch and taken it to the next level. They have come out with hot spring hot pots. These are hot springs that you sit in for relaxation that look exactly like a mala hot pot. Somebody in Chongqing has a lot of money and really, really loves hot pot. Not only is this bath or broth, is it red, but it also has a spicy aroma and has a numbing sensation to it. So literally, it almost is like hot pot. They are even massaging people with huge, whimsical, gigantic chopsticks. I'm not going to say that it's gonna happen, but let's just say I wouldn't be surprised if someone is trying to eat hot pot out of the same bath that they're living in. That would be crazy. You're gonna see a bunch of stuff come out of China that's whimsical, it's gonna be goofy, it's gonna be funny, it's gonna be bad. But what you have to know is that China is so big and that there are so many people and so much stuff is going on and there's so much attention on that country that you will be seeing something interesting probably every day. All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching that episode of AZNN. Yes, the top three AZN news sources on the internet right here. But let me know in the comments below what other news bits I should cover, what else is important, and also what you thought about the questions that I posed throughout this video. I actually really enjoy doing this news segment because one, it's keeping the community informed and thinking, and two, this is not stuff you're gonna see on TV. You could leave those news channels on CNN for like the whole day and you're not gonna come across one of these articles. Thank you to all the news sources that I use, but until next time, we out. Peace. And I'm not even gonna, yo, and straight up, I wouldn't even be surprised if someone is in the hot spring dipping. I cannot. So it would be.